guides us, oh love of the Lord, and let your heart be strong, and your hope let it be in the Lord. Let all your hope let it be in the Lord. Let all your hope be in the Lord. Let all your, let all your hope, let all your hope be in the Lord. Let all your hope, let all your hope be in the Lord. As for me, in my distress, I felt far away from you. But day and night I cried to godly one, for the Lord will preserve the faithful. That's you and me, and love of the Lord, and let your heart be strong, and all your hope let it be in the Lord. Let all sing it out. Oh, all my hope is in you, Lord. Yes, all my hope is in you, Lord. All my hope, all my hope is in the Lord. Hey, everyone, I thought I would get on tonight and sing Psalm 31. And I love this psalm. So I thought I would get on and sing Psalm 31. And I always believe that the right people get on at the right time to hear the right psalm. And tonight I'm going to be singing Psalm 31, giving you a couple of choruses that you can actually take and sing this psalm over yourself. So I keep looking over here at my phone so I can see when this video starts so that I can say your names. Oh, and I see, woohoo! Is this it? All right, I see you. Woo! Okay, hold on 1 second. I'm gonna turn. All right, this is great. So hello, Brandy and Laura. Hello, Roger. Oh, how do I say? And P-A-T-R-E-A, Patrice? Patrice Douglas and Nancy and Barb. Hi, Barbara Scott. And is that how I say it's Patrice? Is that how you, is it Patrice? Is that how I say your name? And Danielle and Brandy Joe. And is it Diane, Tracy and Deborah and Brian and Jenny, right? Jenny and Joy. Awesome. So if you're just now tuning in, do me a favor right now, Danielle, and press your share button so that Psalm 31 can go out all over social media, because it's a powerful song that David actually wrote and sang over himself when he was discouraged, depressed, and dismayed. And he, by singing his writings, by singing Psalm, by writing Psalm 31 and singing it out, we actually see the progression that the psalm actually begins to encourage him. And that's why I love singing the psalms. So if you're just getting on, Carmen and Patrice and Jessica, press your share button. If you would like a copy of our 24/7 worship, or if you would like a sample from our 24/7 worship, if you've got your phone, then text 313131, so that's 313131, and don't worry that it's only six numbers. Text 313131, and in that where you write your message, put the word worship and then a space and then your email address, and we will send you a free sample from our 24/7 worship radio, which we have now, and this makes me excited. We have over 50 hours of the Psalms, Psalm 1 through Psalm 60 plus Psalm 91, as equipping tools, because this is how David fought his battles, his real battles with people and his emotional battles in life. What did he do? He sang out his meditations, which would have been from the Torah or the first five books of the Bible. He simply sang them out, and that's how he fought his battles. And I believe if it worked for David, it will most certainly work for you, Gary, and it will work for you, Jessica, and it will work, or Jesse, and it will work for me. So I love to sing the Psalms. If you're like watching and saying, gosh, I would like to go deeper in the Psalms or in worship, we have listed some links in this thread that you can press on and just get equipped in a better way. And one of the things that I know we put in there, I personally love to sing out of the Passion Translation. So I have my Purple Passion Translation that Joan Hunter sent me, because I love purple. But we're just going to dive in tonight. I'm going to give you some choruses. And hello, Sarah B., praying for you. Hello, Cindy New and Laura. And I want to encourage you, stay on. Because I'm asking the Lord for prophetic words to sing over you, to prophesy over you. But it always, I don't know, they just have to bubble up. I'm not so good on the spot, but an excellent way to start is singing the psalm. So I want to take Psalm 31 and sing it over you. Like I said earlier, press your share button if you're on Facebook, and hello YouTube, press that share button so that Psalm 31 can go out. And I want to give you a couple of these choruses that I believe will encourage you and help you fight emotional battles as well as just battles in life. And if you say, gosh, my son or my daughter or mother or father, they're really struggling with, you know, just depression or dismay or discouragement, you can stand right where you are in your house or wherever you're watching from and sing these choruses. Just point yourself in the direction that they are, because I believe what the Bible says, Hebrews 4:12, the word of God is alive and full of living power. So this alive word, when we sing it, it doesn't just dissipate. It doesn't just fall to the ground. It actually goes forth. And every single person who's watching tonight, you, beloved, you become the target and the landing spot for Psalm 31. Expect the Lord to touch you in your innermost emotions, because that's what David said the Word of God did for him. And that's what it will do for us. If you're watching on Facebook and you see that pop-up window, you can actually put your email address in there and we'll send you a free sample of our 24/7 worship radio. If not, you can, if you're watching on YouTube, text 313131 and put worship space your email address, and we will send you a sample of our 24/7 worship radio, which I believe is an equipping tool for life, and that is singing the Psalms. So let's jump in to Psalm 31. David is depressed. He's discouraged, and he sets up this psalm, and he writes about his dismay, and his heart was discouraged. But then right in the middle of Psalm 31, he writes, "As for me, in my distress, I felt far away from you, God, but I cried out to you day and night, and you heard me." And then it's as if David does this full turn and he begins to preach this sermon in the last two scriptures, and he says, "Oh, love the Lord, you his godly ones, for the Lord will preserve the faithful." He will keep you. He will preserve you for decades and decades. And then he says, "Oh, love the Lord, let your heart be strong and your hope be in the Lord." So I want to sing this over you tonight. If someone is sick in their body, if they're struggling with discouragement, write their name in here. Let me know where you're watching from. I love when the nations get on in different cities and states, and expect the Lord to encourage you and break off those crusties of discouragement and dismay, because that is what singing the Psalms did for David, and that is what it will do for you tonight. Psalm 31, I believe that the right people get on at the right time to hear the right song. And tonight it's Psalm 31. But you know what? All scripture heals and frees and encourages. It encourages, it inspires, and it empowers. So stay on. I'm asking for the Lord to give me some prophetic words. Don't click off, because I want to minister to you tonight. And here we go. We're going to start. Psalm 31, David writes, "As for me, in my distress, I felt far away from you. Psalm of David, and he writes, But then suddenly, singing out his words. trace. And Elminen, E-L-M-I-E-N, it'll work for you, Laura and Janice. And Melinda and Kimberly, it'll work for Penny Hayes. So let me give you this chorus that David sang out, and it literally shifted his discouragement to faith and hope in God. And he wrote, "Oh, love of the Lord, you his godly ones, for the Lord will preserve the faithful. And oh, love of the Lord, and let your heart be strong, and your hope let it be in the Lord." This is our key. He said, "Let all your hope let it be in the Lord. Don't hope in anything but the Lord and his word and his word and his name." So here's our chorus. Oh, love of the Lord, you his godly ones, for the Lord will preserve the faithful. Oh, love of the Lord, and let your heart be strong, and all your hope let it be in the Lord. Let all your hope let it be in the Lord. All my hope is in you, Lord. We sing it out. All my hope is in you, Lord. I believe it. All my hope is in you, Lord. I believe it. All my hope is in you, Lord. Psalm 31, Psalm 31. I'm singing it out over you, Candace and Ariel and Bonnie. Hey, everyone, if you're just getting on, do me a favor, press your share button so we can share Psalm 31. If you would like a free sample from our 24/7 worship radio where Psalm 31 is, you can either put your email in that pop-up window if you're on Facebook, or if you're on YouTube or watching it later, you can text 31 31 31 31 31 31. You can text, and in that text write worship and then a space and then your email address, and we will send you a free music download from our 24/7 worship radio, because I am passionate about equipping believers and non-believers in the Word of God. I want non-believers to turn and follow and love the Lord with all of their heart and soul. And I will tell you, an equipping tool that is simple and is easy is just singing the Psalms like David did. And Psalm 31 is a great psalm if you're discouraged or dismayed, or if you need hope. David, in this season of his life where he was dismayed and discouraged, he meditated on the Torah, the first five books of the Bible. And in those meditations, he wrote his story, and we have the Psalms. But the Word of God, Hebrews 4:12 says that the Word of God is alive and full of living power. So this is how I can actually equip the most amount of people in the simplest of ways, and that is putting a melody line to these verses in the Psalms. And therefore, you know what? Bessie and Marie and Donna, you can sing your way to hope and encouragement the same way that David did. This was his equipping tool. He sang out the Psalms, and I believe that the right people get on at the right time to hear the right song. And tonight it's Psalm 31. So if you're just getting on, don't turn it off, because I'm asking the Lord to give me some prophetic words to encourage you tonight. So, and I gotta warm up a little bit. Penny Hayes and Patrice, I think that's how I say your name, and Michael and Terry and Kristen. Psalm 31, David sang, as for me in my distress, I felt far away from you. If you feel like that tonight, don't worry, because David gives us the answer. I love David's honesty. He just tells God the way he feels. He's not ashamed of his feelings. He just says, God, I feel hopeless. I feel discouraged. I feel dismayed. And then he sings his way to freedom. You can sing your way to healing and hope and inspiration and inner strength. And David just said, as for me in my distress, God, I felt far away from you. Right here. Oh, love of the Lord. get in line with the word of God that is alive, that is alive, and it's working even now as we sing it, as we sing it out. Psalm 31, David sang it out when he needed hope, when he needed faith and strength and healing in his emotions, in his mindset. He sang out, in your secret place, God, you will hide us from the strife of men. In your presence, God, you will keep us. You're our rock and our strong. Tell you what, this is how David fought his emotional battles, and I love how he was so honest with God, and he said, I'm dismayed, God, I feel far away from you, and he just sang out his emotions. But those words he sang out from his meditations were from the Torah, the first five books of the Bible. And they had their perfect way in David's heart, in his life, in his mind, in his soul. And suddenly, Psalm 31, if you sing it out just like David sang it out, he sang it loud, these words, Psalm 31, they are alive and full of living power, they are alive and full of living power, they will heal you, they will knock off the crusties of discouragement, depression, dismay, and hope will find its perfect place in you, Laura, in you, Jennifer, in you, is it Tita, Deborah, and Bonnie, and Carmen, and Laura. This is he fights our battle, but this is how we fight our battle. We sing out the word of God. We sing out the Psalms. This is how David found hope again. He simply sang out his meditations straight from his word. And if it worked for David, it'll work for you and me and me and you. Changing disciples. God, it's a lie. The word of God, Psalm 31. So once again, here's your chorus. Oh, love the Lord, you his godly ones, for the Lord will preserve the faithful. That's me, yes it is. And oh, love the Lord, let your heart be strong, and all your hope let it be in the Lord. Let all my hope let it be in the Lord, in his word. Let all my hope let it be in the Lord, in his word. Let all my hope let it be in the Lord. He will preserve you. Okay, God, that is good news. That is good news. Okay, if you're just getting on, press your share button so that Psalm 31 goes out far and wide. It is an incredible, it's an equipping tool that we can pick up, sing this chorus, and bring it into our life. This is how we fight our battles of discouragement, lack of hope, when we feel a distance from God. This is what we do. We pick up this equipping tool called Psalm 91. Or not Psalm 91. That's another one that's really good, though. Psalm 31. And sing this out. Even these last two scriptures. Oh, love of the Lord, you his godly ones, for the Lord will preserve the faithful. That's us. Oh, love of the Lord, and let your heart be strong, and all your hope let it be in the Lord. Oh, let all my hope let it be in the Lord. You know what? You can take that chorus and you can sing it all through the week, and you can sing yourself to hope and encouragement and break off the crusties of dismay and despair and discouragement, just like David did, because these words are powerful. So come on, I love that. Hey, press your share button. If you would like a copy of our 24/7 worship radio, I mean, if you would like a sample, we have over 50 hours of the Psalms where I'm singing straight from the Psalms, from Psalm 1 through Psalm 50, no, through Psalm 60, now plus Psalm 91, plus Psalm 139. And these are equipping tools for life. It's how I have lived my life in God and fought every single battle singing these Psalms. And so, hey, I just want to equip you with something that has pulled me out of discouragement and dismay, depression over and over. And it is doing what David did, singing his meditations, which would have been from the Torah, the first five books of the Bible. And he put his life story right in the middle of those meditations. And we have the Psalms. If it worked for David, it will work for you, because the Word of God is alive and full of living power. And I love that. So do me a favor, press your share button. And I want to ask the Lord for some prophetic words to minister to some people tonight, because I love doing that. And if you're watching on YouTube, you can actually text 313131. Text the word worship and then space, and then your email address, and we will also send you a sample to equip equipped you. That is the point of singing the Psalms. It doesn't matter if you're a singer, if you need to be equipped for life, the Psalms and a melody is your equipping tool. So amen, that's awesome. If you would like to go deeper in the Psalms, we have a lot of links right there in this thread that you can press on those links and just dive deeper into worship or the Psalms, and because I believe they are equipping tools for every emotional and physical battle you will ever face in life. So Lord, I thank you and I ask you that you would give me some prophetic words for people tonight. And I know Cindy knew I have prophesied over you before because I love your name, new. So God bless you, Laura and Kristen. I don't know if I've prophesied over you before. I love your name, Kristen Riddle. I love that. There's lots of, and what psalm is it? Psalm 40, isn't it Psalm 49? I think, hold on here. Psalm 49. Oh yeah, Psalm 49. So Kristen Riddle, here's your psalm, Psalm 49. Listen, one and all. Listen, both rich and poor together, all over the world, meaning this is for everybody. Everyone listen to what I have to say, for wisdom will come from my mouth. Words of insight and understanding will be heard from the musings of my heart. Okay, hold on, because some translations, let me find it here, because some translations actually say, I will sing out a riddle. Okay, hold on, is it here? Okay, here we go. This is the New Living Translation, Kristen Riddle, and it says, listen to this, all you people. Pay attention, everyone in the world, high and low, rich and poor, for my words are wise and my thoughts are filled with insight. And in verse 4, and this is a psalm of the sons of Korah, verse 4 says, I listen carefully to many proverbs and solve riddles with inspiration from a harp. So, Kristen Riddle, you have got a great name, and I want to encourage you to sing and study Psalm 49. Another translation actually says, I will listen. It's something like, I will listen to heaven's inspiration, and I will sing out what heaven is telling and revealing for me to sing. So Kristen Riddle, I believe you are coming into an amazing season where the Lord is going to open your mind as you study the Word, as you sing the Psalms. And I'm serious, Kristen Riddle. I believe the Lord is going to give you a deeper insight and revelation into the Word, but also into what season, what your family is going through. The Lord is going to give you insight into each family member and how to minister to them, what to say to them. I believe, Kristen Riddle, that you're going to solve the riddles or questions in other people's life that is around you, meaning people are going to come to you with questions like, how do I walk through this? How do I do this? And the Lord is going to give you heaven's inspiration. You're going to have a knowing bubbling up from the inside, and you're going to have words to say that our heaven's inspiration, the wisdom of the Lord, is going to bubble up within you, and you're going to have a, just, I hear the word, you're going to have a perfect answer for how to maneuver and walk through the different seasons that those around you are in. Because Kristen, I see like this picture, Kristen Riddle, I see this picture and it's like there's all these people in front of you, but it's like they're all experiencing different things in life. It's like one person is on the mountaintop and everything's glorious. The next person is in the valley of decision. The next person is in, you know, the valley of weeping. And there's all these people in your life. I think they're friends. I think they're family. I think they're people that God is going to bring into your life. And He is saying, study and learn and read Psalm 49, because Psalm 49, Kristen Riddle, I'm going to put this psalm inside of you so that you're going to have wisdom and insight. You're going to have heaven's inspiration in how to speak and encourage every single person that God brings your way or that is in your sphere of influence. And I believe it's going to be heavenly wisdom. It's going to be insight from the Lord. So it's going to be far beyond even your years. Like, you're going to be known as someone with great wisdom. Not only wisdom from the Bible, but wisdom in how you just walk through life in these days. So God bless you, Kristen Riddle. You're going to solve the riddle in many people's lives around you. So, Shaba, hey, that is good news. God bless you, Kristen Riddle, Psalm 49. Listen to my holy song, Heaven's Inspiration. And I will sing out what heaven is revealing for me to sing, or I'll speak it out. Come on. I think that's really good. I love that. Come on. God bless Julie McAllister. Is that how you say it? McAllister. So my name is Julie. So Lord, I thank you for Julie McAllister. And so when I said your name, Julie, Julie McAllister, because your amazing husband said, please encourage my wife. And I there's so many things on here. I don't see everything, but I saw that. Please encourage my wife. Number one, you have an incredible husband. That is really cool. Julie McAllister, I think that's how I say your name. When I said McAllister, the first thing I thought of was this picture right behind me, which is, I'm going to move. I have that arrow right there, which is the Alabaster. And I mean, your name is not Kim Alabaster, but I feel like that is the scripture for you. And it is this scripture right here is, I think this one is from, let me see, I think it is from John. I know it's from John, but there's a certain reference that I want. Okay, it is John 12. And this is the last day, the last week of Jesus's life. And he goes to the home of Mary. And there's two different times when Jesus is anointed that week. One time it is by another Mary. This particular time it is from Mary of Bethany, because Jesus went to supper to Mary and Martha's house. And it says that Mary picked up an alabaster jar filled with nearly a liter of extremely rare and costly perfume. It says the purest extract of nard, or costly oil. And it says she anointed Jesus' feet. Then she wiped his feet dry with her hair, and the fragrance of the costly oil filled the house. And so when I said Kim McAllister, I just thought of this picture behind me, alabaster. And I feel like the Lord wants you to know, Kim, that even in seasons where we might not totally understand what we're walking through, we don't, you know, it's not a season of breakthrough joy. You know, it is a season where we might feel the residue of discouragement and dismay. Well, number one, that's Psalm 31. That is your battle. That's your weapon of warfare, Psalm 31. Sing it over yourself. But remember, I feel like the Lord, Kim McAllister, wants you to know that when you love him through the seasons, I call them seasons of unknowing, meaning I don't know why I'm going through this, meaning when will there be breakthrough? When you love him through those costly times, when it's weighty, when it's hard, when it's just day to day, it's day by day, step by step, choice by choice, and yes by yes. And you just get up and you set your heart, I'm gonna love him, I'm gonna love him. I feel like the Lord wants you to know, Kim McAllister, that it is beautiful to God. You know, and sometimes I don't understand why some people get immediate breakthrough or immediate healing or, you know, immediate hope or immediate deliverance. Some people do, and you might, but some people, it is this getting up in the morning, it's this every single day, just day by day, step by step, choice by choice, yes by yes. And in the getting up and just making a choice to love God, making a choice, keep Psalm 31, keep John 12 on your lips. In that, we're like the person that Jesus, you know, touched, and he was healed as he walked along. And I feel, Kim, there's two things the Lord wants you to know. Number one, your love for him when there's a emotional swirl going on, it is beautiful to God because you're choosing to love him when it's hard. Sometimes it's easy to love him when everything's wonderful, but you know, when it's hard, that it's hard. And that is so beautiful. And it is like that costly oil that is poured out. It is beautiful to God. And I feel like Kim McAllister, that the Lord just says over you that your life is beautiful and your yes is beautiful. Even sometimes if you have a weak yes, it's beautiful to God. But I also feel that as you just say yes, I mean, just, oh, love the Lord. I am one of the faithfulness. I will trust in the Lord. I will hope in his word. I will hope in his name. As you work that muscle, you know, I'm just going to get up today. I'm going to press through. It's almost as if you are like that one who gets up and is healed and breaks through and breaks through any shadow of unknowing, any discouragement, any need of healing, that as you go, the Lord is going to touch you, empower you. He's going to strengthen you. And I feel like in Jesus' name, just anything that has been coming against you, in the name of Jesus, we just curse in Jesus' name. We break that power off in Jesus' name. We ask God you would send your messengers of fire, your angels to surround her, to bear her up in your hands, lest her foot trip on a rock. Psalm 91. And I thank you for your encouragement, your breakthrough inspiration, your inner strength, and your inner hope that you are putting within Kim McAllister right now as a free gift. The past, it is deleted. It is gone. I feel like the Lord says, don't look backwards, look forwards, because it is immeasurably better than you could hope for or dream up. I believe that is Ephesians 3. Just keep your eyes looking forward. God bless you, Kim. God bless you, Kim. Amy, I love that. Come on. And you know what? If you heard those couple prophetic words, and if you're like, hey, you know, man, I like that, I want it, just grab it. The prophetic word, it's like seeds, and you throw it out. And as you throw those prophetic words out, those seeds, you grab them and you say, this one's mine. So grab those prophetic, come on, just those prophetic words. And so anyway, amen and amen. God bless you, Olga and Deborah and Rebecca and Laura. If you're just getting on, press your share button so that this can go. Psalm 31. Oh, love the Lord, you his godly ones, for the Lord will preserve the faithful. That's you and me. And oh, love the Lord, and let your heart be strong, and all your hope let it be in the Lord. This is how we fight our battles. Let all my hope, let it be in the Lord. God bless you, April. April, this is your month. I love the name April because I love April. April, this is your month. I really believe that. I believe that it's a breakthrough month for you. I see what is your last name? April, is it April Gunther? I believe this is a breakthrough month for you. And just as Song of Solomon chapter 2, when the beloved says, you know, come up here, come up, come up, because the rains are gone, the snow is gone, the season of weeping is over, the flowers are blooming, the sound of the turtle dove is in the land again. The Lord says it's new, it's a new season for you, April, and let your name remind you to look, to be expectant. April, I think the Lord says to you, be expectant this month and look. I mean, literally, look around for the breakthrough and the breaking out of new things and just the word of God in your life. I think there's new doors for you and new strategies. I think there's new, you know, there's a new crossroad for you in this season, and it's good. It is a Song of Solomon 2. Come up, come up. It doesn't mean it's easy because the beloved invites the beloved, or however you say it, the Shulamite, to literally, hey, come up here, climb this mountain with me. So it doesn't mean it's easy, but it means that the Lord is saying, I want to show you what I created you for. and it's great. So April, I believe this is going to be a good month for you. You're going to see some breakthroughs and some invitations that you might feel you're not ready to say yes to, but the Lord says, say yes. I feel that the Lord says, say yes, you're ready. And April, don't ever forget your name. And April really is Song of Solomon, chapter 2. And that's a great verse. So amen. That is, I'm going to take that for myself. That's a great one. So if you're just getting on, press your share button. If you would like a sample of our 24/7 worship radio, you can text 313131 or 313131. You can text that and write the word worship and then space and your email in there. And we will send you a free sample of our 24/7 worship radio, which now we have over 50 hours of soaking worship straight from the Psalms, Psalm 1 through 60. And also, I sang through the Christmas story during the Christmas seasons, and it is equipping tools in different choruses to help you in every single emotional or physical battle we will face in life. That is how David used the Psalms, and we can too. So I love that. If you are not in America, then you can just message me your email and we will get you that sample, because it is equipping tools, and I love that. I am part of the staff at the Healing Rooms Apostolic Center in Santa Maria, California. If you're saying tonight, I need extra prayer, I need personal prayer for healing, if you will, and we'll put this up in a little, Patricia, where are you from? Are you from, I don't know if you're from Canada, maybe you are. If you need personal prayer, if you will, and I'll, we'll put this website up, which is healingroomssmv.com. And God bless you, April. Healing Rooms, thank you, my beloved son. Thank you. So if you see this healingrooms.com online ministry, if you will press that link, it will take you straight to our sign up, where you can sign up for personal prayer for a live Zoom call. Rick and Lori Taylor are the directors of our Healing Rooms Apostolic Center, and they have trained an amazing staff in how to pray for you, and we have got incredible testimonies of deliverance and healing and breakthrough by people simply signing up for a prayer over a live Zoom. So take advantage of that, our online ministry. You can also sign up for personal prophecy, and my good friend Sabrina Walsh, she has trained an amazing team of people that will prophesy over you, encourage you, again, through a live Zoom call. You can just sign up for a day and a time. And we've had, again, incredible testimonies for people that were like, they were spot on. So no matter where you live in the earth, take advantage of that. So anyway, amen and amen.